night, I'm going for a fancy meal in a place where there'll be a bunch of people who know lots of cool shit about electronics. So I thought it would be fun to make an outfit that incorporates wearable electronics and some lights and stuff like that. And I stick by that. That is a good idea. What isn't a good idea is waiting until the night before to do absolutely anything about it. Technically, I have done something. I've ordered these 100 tiny RGB LEDs, the individually addressable sort that I can program to twinkle and do cool rainbow effects and stuff like that. I just snap them off, attach them to a dress, solder some lengths of wire between them, and then hook it all up to an Arduino that will control how the lights change color. The only downside is that each one of them has 6 individual connections to solder on the back of it, which is an absolute hassle, especially when your soldering iron is as shit as mine. Before I do any soldering, I can save myself some work by figuring out how many LEDs I want to include, which means deciding what kind of pattern I want to arrange them in. I want minimum effort, maximum impact, and I don't want my nipples to light up. So what can I do that satisfies those 3 criteria? An egg timer. Because nothing says, I know electronics, like a giant glowing egg timer on your chest. And by egg timer, I mean hourglass. And by hourglass, I basically just mean one big triangle up here on my chest and an inverted one somewhere below it. I figure that'll look different enough that however it lights up, it'll be cool. And if I have time, I can program some cool animation effects that will make it look like it's timing something. But speaking of time, it's like 7 p.m. already, so let's get on with it. Oh, and this is the dress I'm going to destroy. I'm gonna figure out where the LEDs go by putting it on, sticking a piece of paper to myself and drawing dots in the mirror, because as I mentioned, I don't have a lot of time. Welcome to my bathroom again. Basically, I think I don't really want any LEDs lower than about here. So if we make that the tip of the triangle, I want to make sure I spread the LEDs out enough so they don't just look like a blob. So I think I've only really got room for 3 lines, which is good news from a soldering perspective. Oh, drawing in the mirror is very hard. And then imagine something very similar, but here. Now I know how much wire I'm gonna need to solder between all of the LEDs, so I can get started with the boring bit. Now that I've got it all soldered up, it is time to check whether these LEDs actually come on. I've just put some basic example code on the Arduino. Moment of truth. Yes! Success! I'm also gonna put a blob of hot glue on the back of each of these to support the crap solder connections that I've just made. Welcome back to my bathroom. Now I figure if I pin these bits of paper to myself and then very carefully take the dress off,
Then I'll know exactly where to make the holes to put the LEDs and where to sew them on. So let's try to do that. The trick is not to stab yourself. Oh, yep, that was flesh. Okie dokie, that's one pin down, several to go. Minimal injuries so far. Oh God. This bottom one is going to be much harder to do without stabbing myself. Ah! No pain, no gain. Ow! Oh, what am I doing? Oh, one more for luck. Just because I'm a massive masochist. And I'm not going to show you the taking the dress off part.
I've taken the dress off, and now what I'm going to do is cut some teeny tiny little holes where I want my LEDs to go. And now for the super fun part, threading the needle. I did it! Yes! Time to sew the first one on. Okay, the sewing is over. It is a bit of a mess, but the main thing is I finished. So the next thing to do is to try it on, make sure it doesn't electrocute me or immediately catch fire. Ta-da! At the moment, I've basically just got example code running on this. It's an LED strip sketch from the Adafruit website. It goes through a color wipe in a few different colors, then some rainbows and some twinkles. Due to time constraints, I only managed to program one custom lighting effect myself, which is a fading hourglass pattern, which good timing, I think, is happening right now. And because I suck at maths as well as soldering, it actually took me a really long time to do. So I'm gonna miss the drinks reception before dinner. But when you walk in looking this good, who cares? Another thing that would have been nice is to hide these electronics in the shoulder pads, which is part of the reason that I chose this dress. But if you set your sights high on a one-day build with 70 individual solder connections, you are going to be disappointed. My inconspicuous solution is to stuff all the electronics in this bag and then peg it to the back of the dress, because I'm basically assuming that the lights in the front are going to be distracting enough that no one's going to care what's going on behind. I'd love to revisit this project and do it properly, but I think it looks pretty effective for one evening's work. What have I learned? I've learned not to use stiff stranded wire for soldering and or wearables, and everything looks better with LEDs. Even me. I'm off to drink wine in a ballroom while glowing, so see you next time. See what it looks like with the lights out? Yeah, let's turn the lights off. Thinking about, oh yeah, there's a motion sensor. Lighting is not kind close up. Really brings out my eye bags. That's horrifying. Why am I filming myself doing that? Tomorrow night, I am going out for a fancy dinner with a bunch of people who know lots of cool shit about electronics. lucky me. Always gets worse. Always gets worse. It's my life motto. I want it on a t-shirt. It always gets worse. Positivity. It's just this jumper, isn't it? You just don't like it. If you stuff it down your trousers, maybe you'll like it a bit more. That sounds so awful. Oh, I actually pinned that one to my flesh. Oh God, my legs.